welcome to Catalan News. The Catalan government has put a declaration of independence on hold after a very intense day in Parliament. President Puigdemont stated that Catalonia has won the right to be independent, but has suspended any possible declaration of independence for a few weeks, urging Spain to engage in negotiations following recommendations from the international community. In Madrid, however, they refused to negotiate on Catalonia's self-determination, saying the speech was inadmissible and vowing to take action. Here at Catalan News, we'll explain everything about it. Let's begin. Catalan President Carles Puigdemont arrived in Parliament at 5 p.m. for a speech that was due to start at 6, but events were delayed by an hour following conversations he held with different groups and international authorities. Calls for caution and to avoid a full clash collision with Spain, especially after the October 1st repression against the referendum, were heard. Puigdemont said Catalonia had earned the right to be independent, seeming to offer one last chance for dialogue.
Arribats en aquest moment històric, i com a president de la Generalitat, assumeixo en presentar-los els resultats del referèndum davant de tots vostès i davant dels nostres conciutadans el mandat del poble que Catalunya esdevingui un estat independent en forma de república. Això és el que avui fem amb tota solemnitat per responsabilitat i per respecte. I amb la mateixa solemnitat, el govern i jo mateix proposem que el Parlament suspengui els efectes de la declaració d'independència per tal que en les properes setmanes emprenguem un diàleg sense el qual no és possible arribar a una solució acordada.
Our colleague Rachel Bathgate is in Parliament now, from where she has followed the speech by the Catalan president and members of the chamber. Rachel, good evening. How was the atmosphere there?
Hello, Alex. The atmosphere here at Catalan Parliament has been very, very tense all day, as its halls teemed with international journalists, more than 1,000 of them, and local journalists as well, that all came to hear what Catalan President Carles Puigdemont would announce would be the next steps, politically speaking, for Catalonia following the independence referendum on October 1st. At 7 p.m., the Parliament plenary did start, and Catalan President Carles Puigdemont did, in fact, announce what would happen. He said that the results, the 90% of people that voted yes on the October 1st referendum, that the results were binding and would in fact lead to independence, effectively declaring independence. However, he was very clear as to the fact that the effects of this independence referendum and declaration would be suspended for a couple weeks while Catalonia awaited international mediation. He did not speak of any specific sources that offered mediation, but he did say that there were many, some to be kept private, and others that had been made public. He also did say that this decision that he came to was not a personal one. However, he had spoken to many sources and gotten much advice about this. He also continued to speak about dialogue, as well as offering his respect to the rest of Spain and to other politicians. Other politicians and other parties, however, had much to say as a rebuttal to the president.
Esto ha sido la crónica de un golpe anunciado, de un golpe a la democracia, de un golpe al sentido común, de un golpe a la institución de este Parlamento, de un golpe a nuestro Estatuto de Autonomía y, sobre todo, un golpe a un proyecto común que se llama España y que se llama Unión Europea.
Però aviam si ho he entès bé. Vostè assumeix un mandat que jo discuteixo i al mateix temps diu que proposa suspendre una declaració no feta. És complexa.
I espero que la declaració d'avui sigui llegida, d'avui vostè, president, com aquesta voluntat, com un gest en aquest sentit. Recerca de contactes, gestos de distensió, recerca de facilitar les mediacions que tant sindicats, col·legis, moviments veïnals estan reclamant.
El Estado de Derecho y la democracia no van a permitir ningún Estado independiente en forma de república en Cataluña, ni con su declaración de presente, ni por etapas, ni por diferido. Me he explicado de manera muy clara, señor Puigdemont, no va a haber ninguna república independiente de Cataluña.
Avui iniciem una nova etapa de lluita, perquè avui ja no podem suspendre els efectes de la voluntat de més de 2 milions de persones.
Although the independence declaration has been temporarily suspended, the Catalan government, with the two pro-independence parties that support it, has symbolically called it anyway. The politicians have signed a document explaining the process that is starting, with the declaration of a Catalan Republic setting in motion the transitional law asking for international recognition if Spain continues to refuse to engage in dialogue. The Spanish government has never been willing to negotiate a referendum of independence with Catalonia and has actually refused to engage in discussions up to 18 times. Today's appeal by the Catalan president has been described as inadmissible by Madrid as it opens the door to a declaration of independence at some point in the future. So many doubts now arise on what will happen next.
How might Madrid respond to Catalan President Puigdemont's statement? Suspension of Catalan self-government? Prison? A state of emergency? There is much speculation over how Mariano Rajoy's executive might react, and the potential scenarios are explosive to say the least. Enforcing Article 155 of the Spanish Constitution is the most commonly mentioned measure. It would mean suspending Catalonia's self-government. Taking over government, dissolving the parliament, and taking full control of the police and finances would be some implications. Some sources say it could be enforced in a week. The Spanish vice president has not ruled it out.
Y le corresponde al gobierno de España, a través del Senado, porque es una decisión, quiero recordar, también del legislativo, adoptar medidas.
Arresting the president is also on the table. A spokesman of Spain's ruling party said yesterday that Puigdemont could end up like one of his predecessors, Luis Companys.
La historia no hay que repetirla y esperemos que mañana no se declare nada, porque a lo mejor el que lo declare acaba como el que lo declaró hace 83 años.
Companys declared a Catalan state in 1934 and was immediately arrested. 6 years later, he was executed by the Franco regime. Legal action is almost certain. The Spanish Attorney General is preparing a lawsuit charging the Catalan president with rebellion. That could mean up to 20 years in prison. The Spanish vice president neither disclosed nor ruled out any action that might be taken. Some commentators have speculated that Rajoy could even declare a state of emergency. Amid all these extreme scenarios, is there room for dialogue or mediation as the Catalan president has been demanding since the referendum? So far, the Spanish government has flatly rejected any need for mediation. Mariano Rajoy may provide some of the answers in a statement tomorrow evening in the Spanish Parliament.
The Catalan pro-independence movement has always been very active in the streets, gathering hundreds of thousands of people every year to defend statehood. And today was no exception, with many gathering near Parliament in eager anticipation of what President Carles Puigdemont would say in his key speech. Even as last-minute calls were made for Puigdemont to step back and not declare independence, crowds remained unperturbed, waving Catalan flags and banners proclaiming independence from Spain.
As lawmakers listen to the Catalan president, thousands of independent supporters gather close to the Catalan parliament to follow together what Carles Puigdemont had to say. In total, more than 30,000 people, according to Barcelona's local police. Most of them, according to ACN reporters on the ground, were hoping for the long-awaited declaration of independence. Puigdemont's speech, though, was not received with the joy that many anticipated. People cheered the president's words when he talked about Catalan Republic and received the imminent declaration of independence with euphoria. Right after, some people booed the president when he suspended the declaration calling for mediation and dialogue. Some even left, disappointed. But not only were MPs and independent supporters following today's events. Today's session in the Catalan parliament prompted the interest of news outlets from all around the world. More than 1,000 journalists followed the Catalan president's speech in the parliamentary chamber. At least 350 came from international newspapers, TVs, and radios.
And people before, they were kind of like not understanding what that was about, why Catalonians wanted the independence. And little by little, people are becoming very curious.
Yeah, we're all very interested in the situation. It could be the birth of a new nation. It could also be a big political crisis with Spain and Catalonia. So, there's a very huge interest for it.
Never before had so many reporters been in the Catalan parliament, and never before have journalists from so many different countries followed events at the chamber.
The decision by Catalan President Puigdemont to put on hold the Declaration of Independence while recognizing the right to be a state seemed to follow calls coming from Brussels urging caution to avoid a violent conflict. In an unprecedented move, only a few hours before the Catalan president's speech, the European Council president, Donald Tusk, sent a message to Barcelona.
Today, I ask you to respect, in your intentions, the constitutional order and not to announce a decision that would make such a dialogue impossible. Diversity should not and need not lead to conflict, whose consequences would obviously be bad for the Catalans, for Spain, and for the whole of Europe.
And with this, we finish today's special edition on events in the Catalan Parliament. We leave you with some images from a small town in Catalonia where today they have echoed Puigdemont's calls for an intervention from Europe. We'll be back tomorrow with more information about what's going on in Catalonia. Thank you for watching and see you soon.
I am a Catalan. Today, a province of Spain. But what has been Catalonia? Catalonia has been the greatest...